This is Sanket here, and welcome to the tech content. So here is our first lecture of our course Practical FEM with Ansys Workbench. And in this lecture, we will see the basic of FEA, and we will see user interface of Ansys Workbench. So let's begin. So these are the content of our course, which I'm going to cover. So you can pause and you can read each topics. So I'm going for the next slide. So here are some abbreviations like 1D for one dimensional or CAD, computer aided design, LMB. So you can pause and read all these abbreviations. I'm going to the next slide. So what is history of FEA? The success of FEM started in the 1940s as the need has risen to solve complex structural problem in civil, mechanical and aeronautical engineering. Then in 1940s, mesh discretization methods were developed. Then in 60s, term finite element was introduced. Then in 65, NASA developed one structural analysis system, which is called as NASTRAN. Then in 1967, the first book was published on finite element analysis, and it was written by the great British mathematician O.C. Zinkiewicz. Then in 1970, Ansys software was found. The Ansys software was found because the numerical calculations in FEA are very complex, so we need a software for that. So Ansys was founded at that time. Now, concept of FEA. So in simple word, FEA means divide and conquer. The basic theme of FEA is to divide the domain into small parts. Domain can be surface or volume, and we divide the surface or volume into smaller parts. These smaller parts are called as elements, which are connected at distinct point, and these points are called as nodes. It means we make calculations only at number of points, and then we interpolate the result for entire domain. I'll show you this in next slide. Now, what is meshing? As I said that we divide our domain into smaller parts, and these smaller parts are connected at some distinct points, which are known as nodes. So in FEA, you need to remember these two words, elements and nodes. So consider this is a domain, means this can be surface or volume. So as per FEA, we divide the surface into these smaller parts, and then the smaller parts are called as elements, and these elements are connected at some distinct points, and these points are called as nodes. So in FEA, we calculate the results at these points only, and then we interpolate those results to get value in between this point. If you want to find value at this, we interpolate the result obtained at this point and this point. So this is how FEA works. And the procedure of dividing domain into smaller parts is known as meshing, and the result is mesh. The elements are placed in such a way that no empty spaces exist and they do not overlap. The quality of our solution depends on the size and type of the element in use. Now, what I mean by size of element? Size of element means if you divide our domain into much smaller parts, then we'll get accurate result, but also it will take a lot of time. And what do I mean by types of the elements? We will see this in next slide. So here are some element types: solid, shell, plane, beam, and link. We will do analysis using these elements in further sessions, in further lectures. Now, order of interpolation or shape function. As previously I said, we obtain a result at these points only, means at this node only, and then we interpolate the result for entire domain. So the order of interpolation can be linear, quadratic or cubic. So if you use order of interpolation linear, then our equation of line will be AX plus B. If you use quadratic, our equation of line will be AX square plus BX plus C. And if you use cubic, equation will be AX cube plus BX square plus CX plus D. Now we'll go for the next slide. How can we achieve better result? For that, we can use a better shape functions. It means we can use a shape function of higher order, or we can raise the number of elements, or we can combine both. Now, linear FEM and non-linear FEM. See, these are the two main important terms in FEM, like linear FEM. So this is our stress strain curve. I think everyone knows this. Okay, if we do the analysis between this linear line, means there is a linear relation between forces and displacements, then this analysis will call as linear FEM. And if you do analysis from this point to further, it will called as non-linear FEM. In linear FEM, the stiffness matrix is constant, whereas in non-linear FEM, the stiffness matrix is not constant. The non-linear FEM is used for large deformations. So this is the main difference between this. So at start, our first 10 lectures will be on linear FEM, and later on we'll do problems on non-linear FEM. Now, the component of FEM software. The FEM software usually consists of three main components, like preprocessor, solver, and postprocessor. In preprocessor, you can create or import the geometry. You can create geometry like as you do in CATIA. There are some methods in ANSYS to draw geometry like space claim or design modeler. And also you can import geometries. And also in preprocessor, you can discretize or mesh our geometry. You can define the material and you can assign the material properties. You can apply boundary conditions and loads. So overall, it contains setup of the simulation. The second one is solver. Solver performs the all calculations at the back end. And third one is post-processor. The post-processor is used to view the results directly on the geometry. It can generate animations, it can plot different quantities over the time, or it can create result tables. So these are the main three components of FEM software. So here are some list of softwares which offers these components of FEM. So let's have a look on this. The Abacus, ANSYS, LSDyna, and Calculix offers all three components, like means preprocessor, solver, and postprocessor. Hypermesh provides only preprocessor and postprocessor. ANSA provides only preprocessor, and Patran provides both preprocessor and postprocessor. And Nastran is only solver. On the other hand, some CAD softwares provides FEM solvers, but usually very limited. And here are some list of softwares like CATIA, FreeCAD, ProE, or Creo. In this course, we will look on ANSYS software, including all three components. So this is our task. So in this task, we will create a simulation of range file. I have CAD file of this range, and we will do simulation of this. So after watching today's simulation, you will get familiarized with user interface of ANSYS. We will try different boundary conditions, and we will apply different loads. And also we will apply pressure on the top of the range. So here we go. Now, for starting, let's click on ANSYS Workbench. Or you can search here ANSYS Workbench. Let's click on that. Now this will pop up this window. It will take some time to open. So let's wait for that. Now ANSYS Workbench has been opened. Now, when you open ANSYS, you can see window like this. Here at left side, you can see the toolbox. This toolbox contains various analysis systems. And here you can do analysis of various things like static structural here, or steady state thermal, thermoelectric, transient structural, or analysis of whichever system you want. Suppose we want to do analysis of static structural. So I'll simply click this and I will drag and drop this here. You can also add another analysis system. So here, suppose I want to add transient structural. So I'll simply drag and drop this here. So this each analysis system contains certain cells. Now, this is engineering data. Here, we can define material. Here, you can create or import geometry. And for further cells, we'll do the setup of our simulation. You can also share data between these two. Like suppose I want to share the engineering data of this to this, I'll simply drag and drop this here. So this is linked. You can also share your geometry here, like this. So as of now, I will delete this transient structural. Now here, let's go for a task one. Here you can change our engineering data of material. For that, you can do right click and edit. Now at here, you can see our materials. This material is by default. If you don't use any material, then this material will be assigned to your product. Or here you can add the material. Like suppose I want to add normal steel, I'll add this. Enter. Now here you can see question mark. It means we have not assigned any properties to this. So for that, you can double click on that, and then you can see here you can enter Young's modulus or Poisson's ratio. Okay, so the unit of this is Pascal. Here you can change it to MPa or whatever you want, and you can enter here Poisson's ratio. So I'll go with this structural steel. I delete this. So we'll go with this. Now let's again go to the project tab here. Now geometry, right click on that, and you can create geometry using space claim or design modeler. Here some two options. When you open this, it will open another window. There you can design and develop your own geometry, like as you do in CATIA, CREO, NX. But for today's lecture, I will import geometry of this range. So here you can browse, click on browse and go to that file, click on that and say open. Now next step, we'll go to model, click on that, do right click and click on edit. Now another window will be open, so we need to wait for that. You can see here. Now here is our range. At starting, I'll show you some tools and options. Like here you can change units, like SI or whichever you want. Here you can change the units of angles, degree or radians. Here you can change the unit of rotational velocities, like radians per seconds or RPM. And here you can change units for temperature, like Celsius or Kelvin. As I said, that the first step of FDI is we divide the entire domain into small parts. So what does it mean? It means we create a meshing. So here is option of mesh. Now let's go to the mesh, right click on mesh and generate mesh. It will automatically divide our range into smaller parts like this. In further sessions, we will discuss how to mesh properly, and we will see some mesh refining techniques, because in FDI meshing matters a lot. Now meshing has been done. Now the next step is we need to apply boundary conditions and loads. Now for this problem, we will fix this face, this inner face, this and this, and we will apply pressure of 10 MPa at this side. Okay, I forget to tell you that to rotate this part, you can use your middle button of mouse, like scroll button, and you can rotate it, or by pressing control and using scroll button, you can pan it, and using scrolling wheel, you can zoom in or zoom out. That's it, just remember that. Now firstly, we will fix this inner faces. For that, go to static structural, right click on that, insert and fix support. Now here you can see that geometry is highlighted. It means that we need to select the faces. So while selections, make sure that here this option it choose. Like these three options are, if you want to select pace, you should click on this option. If you want to select age, you can go for this. Or if you want to select any vertices or point, you can choose this. For this case, I need to choose pace. So I'll choose this option. So simply click this, then press Ctrl and select this, this, and this. Make sure that you have pressed Ctrl button. Now click on apply. Four faces. Now the next step is, we want to apply pressure of 10 MPa on this face. So again, go to static structural, right click, insert. Now here you can see there are various options you can apply, like acceleration, pressure, force, and so on. So now I want to add pressure. So here is pressure. So now geometry, select the geometry. I want to apply pressure on this face and this face. So select this, press Ctrl and select this face. For selecting multiple faces, you just need to press your Ctrl button. Now click on apply. Now magnitude, we need to enter here our pressure. Now 10 MPa. 10 MPa means how many zeros on 10? 6. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Enter. Okay, you can change units here from here. Okay, that's it. Now, what is remaining? Solution. Now, what exactly do we need? Do we need stresses? Or do we need deformations? So here, you can give input to ANSYS like what you want. Just right click on that, insert. Now I want deformation. So I will go to deformation and total deformation. Again, I'll go here, insert, and I want stresses. Now, so now everything has been done. Now go on solution, right click on that and solve. Or you can click here, solve. Okay, solve. It will take some time. Yeah, it's done. Just click on this. This will show you our total deformation. Means the red area means it is affected a lot, and this blue means it's affected negligible. So here you can also click on play button to see the animation, like how our part will be deformed. Pause. And this is our equivalent stress. Let's see. At this region, there will be maximum stress, like red region. And the value of the stress will be here. You can see this. That's it. Now, here is end of our first lecture. Thanks for watching. If you like this video, do subscribe our channel and press the bell icon so that you will be get notified when I upload the further sessions.